And we've got a variation and all of that, but they are strictly work right there. There's a lot of the good plants or something.
That one's from the business, so they're making, yeah, she worked on.
Yeah, so they made you their own fertilizer. And they got it. They got money through some of the yogurt. The community group both are going for them and they got $10,000 and one field was.
I saw this morning.
We're talking about it.
Are they doing the tea and tanks or are they doing the fish?
They tea compost and tea is a big mobile. That is like bacon, boil compost.
Yeah.
And it's the same thing that they call compost tea.
Right.
You're doing some talking to people.
Well, I've seen it done in large tanks.
Yeah, that's what they do. In large tanks, it's mobile.
So. I got it.
Oh, I. Yeah, that's our screen.
Yeah, there's Intel, no.
Yeah, I think we're good. We've got email from Abigail, she's not gonna make it.
Okay. So, hi guys, I think we have two visitors that normally we don't have on the committee. And I don't know, you guys just wanna.
Susie Hester and my resident of Portland. I'm also co-chair of cemetery committee. So I would just like to get to know your committee. If you have to come before you, won't you, I know who you all are. So.
And then Diana, you're not normally, you were, I don't know if you're gonna.
Well, she's been part of the committee from the beginning.
Yeah, no, she was.
Yeah, I'm kind of having a hard time hearing. I don't know if it's because of the Zoom being so far away.
Far away, we don't have a long enough cord.
Yeah. Last time you used the conference call, but I know there's a lot of people on Zoom this time.
Yeah.
Should we just
wicked us? Yeah. If we talk really loud, can you hear us?
I can hear you, Peter.
Okay. So everybody's gonna talk really loud. Here's your
screen.
Yeah. So anyway, welcome everybody. Everybody else is. We've got Samantha and Jessica, conservation commission members, and Ted and I, conservation commission members. And Kate and Peter in the city. Everybody. So I think the first item on our agenda was actually want to thank Ted for putting this together, and I think Ted would be the first one up. I think talking about the accreditation problem.
There are a few things going on, and we're, as I mentioned at the last conservation commission, is an update. There are a bunch of things going on. And one is, and we talked about this, sort of the chicken or the egg, is that most people in Portsmouth don't maintain their own properties. They hire somebody to do it. And one of the huge difficulties is that there are very few people in the industry that practice true organic land management. Very, very few. But the leading group is the Northeast Organic Farmers Association. And I think in 1999, they started to put together organic land management standards, which we have been using. And they also put together an accreditation program in organic land management. I have to have been through the accreditation program, as has been Diana as well. And so what we're trying to do is get more people that are accredited in organic land management. So one of the ways to do that is we've asked and they've agreed to, NOFA itself is offered to put on their class for the first time ever in New Hampshire and put it on right here in Portsmouth. So we're excited by that prospect. So there are ways that we thought of already in terms of outreach to the other traditional landscapers and their associations and try to promote it as a way for business to let them know that Portsmouth, and we have inquiries from a lot of other communities around here, they're interested also in encouraging better land management practices. And so there are others that are interested. So what we're doing, we hope, is going to be replicated in other communities, certainly in Dover. And we've heard from Farmington and others. And we've been talking to Barbara from the Conservation Commission or Associations of Conservation Commissions. And she's very, very interested in as well. So we're trying to do it right and do it carefully. So that's one aspect of it, is setting up this that we held maybe late winter or something like that, or almost early spring for the accreditation program. But we would have to work that out with what Jeremy wants to do, who's the director of NOCA Connecticut, that oversees the accreditation program. So, you know, that's one key part of it, and one that will be coming up. The other aspect is creating this online course, which we've got an outline, and I'll turn over to Diana in a little bit to talk about, so that everybody can take this course at home. It's online. We're also going to augment it. The plan is to augment it with some programs, probably over at the library, on organic land management. We've held them in the past, and they've been pretty well attended. Just as a community organization, we held a few in the past, and we held them back, actually, way back in 2017. We had a program we put on here. We put another one in 2018. And Eldridge Lumber at that time was a co-sponsor. They've got a gentleman who also is accredited. It does a good job on teaching a class. Calling John and asking him to do it as well. Last time, the Conservation Law Foundation was a sponsor for our programs. And the Great Big Waterkeeper, I think we've had some informal conversations with those guys, and that's for my aspect. The other aspect is that we're looking for a classroom space for about 30 plus students for whenever we hold this class. And it's 4 days, it's 9 to 4, and we're trying to figure out a space. I have not checked with the library yet. The person that is in charge of this special project is actually my neighbor. So when we can take her outside and ask her to go to find out about it, you know, or what can I do? But so there are things that we have to do. But and then the other aspect and is that from the last meeting, as Diana sort of went through the online program, what we want to do, had an outline of it, and share that with folks and ask for feedback and that kind of stuff. And that's, and I think once we have it, an outline, I think we're ready to go. So, any questions?
I had a question about the website. Is this the website update?
That's the one that you passed out used last time.
Okay.
Send around.
Yeah. Okay. So the one thing that I think I talked to the Think Blue people, and I think we're worried about confusion of the name. So I think we should try to find a different name.
Yeah, that was actually Alan Brady's idea. He said, yeah. Well, we don't think blue, you guys could do Think Green, and that will help each other, you know, synergy.
I
guess they don't worry like,
yeah, about that. But that, other than that.
That's not a problem. That's the other thing we have to do today, is agree on what we want to call this podcast.
Yeah, and I guess that's the question. Is it a program of the city, or is it a group, a different group, like a greater group, the regional organic land care group that is, in terms of the website, is it the website linking to a website, or is it a city presence on the website?
Yeah.
So then I was thinking it'd be good to highlight what we do as a city for organic land care, for sure.
Oh, yeah.
And our commitment to that, and then what the commission's working on, and then We don't have any ordinance yet, but we can talk about the goals of organic land care and maybe at some point we'll be able to update it with an ordinance change. And it could be a place where people can look for information. It looks like there's good links here. So that was those are my biggest comments. Really. And I, you know, I think there's we just have to figure out how to where to put it on the website that people can find it. And then what it links to and make sure those links are okay to link to. Yeah, come up with a good name.
Yeah, great. Danielle, you want to go over a little bit of the website people?
Sure. Do you want me to share my screen?
Sure.
Okay. You gotta enable it for me. About the name, I came up with an alternate name because I talked to Brian Goetz about it and he let me know he was concerned. So I said, no big deal. Green Yards would be an alternative name instead of Think Green. Just something short and sweet.
Green Yards.
Mm-hmm. Green Yards, Portsmouth.
Yeah, we've talked about having it as short as possible. That was the Think Green idea. It's nice and short.
Yep. Yeah, I mean, the taking the think out does it, I think, you know.
So yeah.
Is where the confusion comes in. Yeah. So. I think that's good.
And then you can have a subtitle one of these or something.
Is there other communities that have something like this? No.
I do know of a few. There's in Marin County, they have Yard Smart Marin, which is all one word. Colleague of mine runs that, and that's the one I can think of offhand, but I know there are more.
Providence.
Yeah, Providence does. They have the public education campaign, which we're trying to mimic as much as we can, and there are others. I think there's Good Neighbor Iowa. There's a good, nice campaign that they have. There's all sorts of examples out there. I saw someone else, and I don't remember what community it was, but they had like lawn gnomes, and the gnomes like gave tips and stuff. It was actually really cute.
That's cool. The only reason I was asking was if there was like a standard people use, but it sounds like everybody has their own name, so there's no real benefit in using like a. You know, what are the other communities? Yeah.
Right. The only standard would be just the organic land care standard. So that's, you know, that's what we're basing it on, but you give it our own name.
Yeah, I like Green Yard Sports.
Okay. Yeah. I mean, I'm fine with it. Whatever people want to choose, it works for me. And I really like your idea about highlighting what the city does. We want that to be part of this as well, because you're setting the example for the residents, and if you could do it, you know, on the big city properties, and people can certainly do it on their, in their own yards. So we have full permission from Connecticut NOFA to use their materials. So we link to the standards for organic land care, you can see here, and then we would link to their website because there's no way we can, but we can also upload the PDF for the standards to the city website, and so it would be direct. So any sort of materials like that can just be directly loaded to the city website because we've got permission to use any of them. But the link to search for the AOLCPs would have to go to their website because they have an interactive database for people to search.
What's an AOLCP?
So Accredited Organic Land Care Professional.
Yeah. Okay.
So that's sort of your starting point for finding someone who, you know, has at least taken the time to take the accreditation course and learn and keep up with their accreditation, because you have to renew it yearly. And there is some oversight because, I mean, it is voluntary, but there is some oversight because they will occasionally audit people and make sure that they are doing what they say they're doing. And you know, if it comes to their attention that someone is saying they're organic and using the AOLCP accreditation, but using synthetics or, you know, otherwise greenwashing, they'll lose their accreditation. So it's an important thing for consumers. And I know they're going to be working on updating the standards and also there will be a working group to sort of strengthen the oversight over the AOLCPs and to expand the program as much as they can.
So is the update they have to do the same as the new accreditation, or is it a little easier?
So the standards themselves, they're on the sixth version. So there will be a seventh version. So this way, when you follow the standards, it's the nonprofit and the organization and all the stakeholders that come in and update that periodically. So you don't have to learn all the new things. They will update it to best practices and you just follow that.
I'm sorry, I think I asked the question wrong. I meant the accreditation. Is it hard for people to get? So if they do the whole course, what does it take to get your annual accreditation?
To continue your accreditation, you pay a fee, but what you're supposed to do is continue to take courses
continuing education kind of thing. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, like continuing education credits, CEUs. Yeah. Yep. But it's a little more informal. So, I mean, I've audited the course several times and I take, IPM and all kinds of different courses, and that would, go towards my reaccreditation each year. Also, I don't know, Ted, you mentioned to them that we're trying to get an in-person training in New Hampshire for the first time, right?
Yes, I did. And that we need a classroom for about 30 plus students, and we're on the hunt for one. And we're happy because everybody wants to help.
Is that something that we want to put on this webpage, like announce it, or is it you do not want to go that far and wide?
We don't have it arranged yet, so it's probably premature to do that. But I guess when it happens, then yes, that would be great to put on the website or have the city publicize it, obviously.
Yeah.
I know, Sam, that one of your concerns was that how do we make sure that these people are following the standards? And the good part is that NOFA itself is concerned about this issue and has set up a subcommittee to strengthen that process of auditing and making sure people follow the standards. And I think you're on that committee, aren't you, Diana?
I was invited to be part of the working group.
That's great. One last thing on our plate.
Yes.
I just want to interject. I agree with Sam. It was a little fuzzy to hear you when you were talking about all the pieces, Ted, but since you mentioned it again, I know you said something about reaching out to the library, but I know the new person who's in charge of programming, Christy, I can't think of her last name at the moment. She is very interested in doing a lot of sustainability-based programming at the library. So she might be someone you want to reach out and connect with, because that's one of her priorities for planning programming there. I can send you her contact information. I just can't think of her last name at the moment.
She's the John Kidd.
Yeah, send me your contact information. That'd be great.
Will do.
Diana, do you want to talk more about the website?
Sure. Sorry, I didn't know it was going back to me. Bringing up the NOFA website. And so this is where they have the standards, and the standards themselves are in a PDF form. I have a bound copy. You can purchase copies, but for the purposes of the website, we could just upload this PDF. It's about 60 pages long, but it contains all of the, and I'll just, those are the authors. Yeah. A table of contents with all of the things that are included. And as well as for homeowners specifically, I made this document for, just the suggested copy to go on the website. And this will have the introduction to Organic Lawns and Yards by Sarah Little. And this is really an excellent book it's based on the standards, but aimed directly at homeowners and has a checklist. And it's really straightforward and simple language. So that's something that can be downloaded as well. And we could probably get grant money to get physical copies as well and put like free copies at the library or something for people. And I just put sort of excerpts from it that we could put there. And then there's other resources for people. I didn't want to put too much, you know, just try to keep it simple.
And so I just had a quick question about the other resources. It was sort of like an organic, all natural turf programs and stuff. You have permission to use those documents too, or?
Yes. So I think, let's see, this one is.
Jess, did you have something? Oh, you're muted, Jess.
Sorry. I was just wondering, Diana or Ted, have you considered putting on a list of native plantings or invasive species or to help homeowners navigate that piece at all? Just, you know.
Yes, I think that's a great idea. And they are mentioned in that book. Like I said, I didn't want to include too much, but I think you're right that we should probably put, and I'll just add a note here.
Yeah, the New Hampshire list is, I think, pretty accessible online. We probably could put a link to that.
Yeah.
I think you can get to that pretty quickly.
Soak Up the Rain has a list of native species that you would want to plant too. So you kind of have both.
So yeah, I've just added that on there so that I can add those links. I've put the links here, but ideally anything that is a PDF and that we could, that the IT people could just upload directly to the Portsmouth website so we wouldn't have to deal with broken links later. Like they'll do that. Alan Brady and I discussed this.
Yeah, that would be easy to do. It'd be faster too.
Yeah. So yeah, I like that idea. I think that's a great idea. Thank you, Jessica.
Yeah. I have an overall question, just and maybe this is more for Peter or Diana, because you've talked to the IT people and so, but would there be any conflicts on, you know, how much is that policed on what you can put on?
That's what I want to talk to Alan about. It sounds like he's you know, been pretty open to putting stuff on. What I want to do is make sure DPW is on board and it fits what they're doing. It should all work pretty well. We're gonna have to adjust some things, but that's where I think maybe that's the place to send people so they see that the city's doing it, and then they get more information there. But probably want it in a few places. That's what Alan can help us with. It could be on the Conservation Commission page too. And I think there's also links with our climate action plan with this stuff too. So
you're right.
I don't know. That's more of an IT question, how to organize it on the website, but what do we allow and don't allow? But it seems like if we've got permission for everything and it's information that's just supporting what we already do as a city, we should be okay.
And Alan basically said, you know, once we say it's okay, you know, or that the city says it's okay, city's ready to go. You know?
Yeah, it shouldn't take much. It's not that complicated information, so.
We did it through Stephanie when they upgraded. We added pages for the cemetery committee. And Stephanie did all that. It took him like a day, not even a day. Or
once.
So it was really easy.
Yeah, I just want to talk with a couple of people, talk with Alan and talk with Public Works, Public Forum, and Peter. I'm sure they're all on board. And then it'd be nice if we could figure out a layout. We're getting close to a layout already, it seems like. So. Alan can probably jazz it up too.
Oh yeah.
Right.
Yeah, this is just a rough draft to give them something to start with, and I've designed websites myself, so this should be enough for them to make it look nice. And Alan was pretty much on board and was like, "This is simple and straightforward." So I had had a call with him, and I did speak briefly with Brian Getz, but it's just a matter of getting the permissions and going ahead with it. So I'm happy to meet with anybody and talk to them and help them get all the materials together.
So as this being a rough draft, what would be our next step then for this?
Oh, just let Diana get one. And try to fill in some of the blanks of this.
So, well, I think if you can send me that, what you have there, and this electronically, if I don't have it already, I'll run it by Alan and Public Works before you go too far doing much. But then we might get some feedback on how to lay it out, or Alan can help with the layout, or how not.
Yeah, it doesn't have to be exact. I'm just trying to give some material, but just, you know.
Right. No, exactly. I just, the content is what I'm interested in, not necessarily the layout. But
yeah.
We get to the layout next, but we just want to make sure everybody's all moving in the same direction.
Yeah, sounds good to me.
So like you, the way Peter said, you know, we want to put something in there about the city, what the city's doing. So who would draft that? And when do we have to get
it? We'd probably do that. We look what they have already. They already have some stuff on
there. So there is a lot of stuff.
We might want to update what we have and then work from there to link to this and then see if this has its own place on the website, or if it's under the Conservation Commission, where it's, you know, figure out a good place. That might be what next steps for us is thinking about places, you know, getting some ideas from IT and Public Works and then seeing what the community wants to do.
Okay.
So Kate and I will follow up with that part, the city, you know, the city commissions, I'll call it, but really just clearing the way.
Well, it's a good opportunity to be honest, some of that stuff that's on there daily, you know.
I'm sure.
And so it's a good opportunity to, you know, do all this at once.
Yeah,
and I had some comments on the layout a little bit. So, and I guess with Peter, what you were saying too, to have the city information, you know, where do we put that? And then also, like, it does kind of delve right into, you know, it starts with the full document as a link. And so I'm thinking that might need to change priority a little bit, you know, not have people totally overwhelmed with this link to a document. And give them a little more background information, or divide it out a little bit to, you know, here's what's for the do-it-yourselfers, and here's what's for the
certified people.
Yeah, the certified people, or something like that. And so I don't know when that discussion should be. You know, not talk about now.
Sure. I think the website, you know, is going to need to be reviewed and edited to wait until everybody's happy with it. So, yeah.
So we could do that over from now, or people could just sort of an ongoing thing, give comments to Diana. Or,
well, I don't know who's going to be doing it. I mean, Diana said she's willing, but if Alan takes that role on, I can do it and give him.
I'm fine to work on it with Alan Brady. He and I had a nice conversation, and I think we'd have an easy time putting it together.
Yeah, it shouldn't be too much, right? I mean, but your comments are important, I think. So you want a little more description before you get right into the documents as well.
Yeah, and it might tie in with what you were talking about in the city.
It might be city. Going through the city stuff gets you there.
Yeah.
So do you want it like on this page here, like where I'm at, underneath the subheading where it says it's time to look at our landscapes differently? Are you saying that you would like more introduction there, or?
Yeah, a little bit, but I mean, we can all kind of look at it a little closer, I guess, and just for that kind of thing, because I think the whole concept is great, and I wasn't sure exactly where it was going, so.
Okay, well, once it's up too, we can, I mean, it can be edited at any time, but if we can just get the basic framework up.
That's great, yeah. Okay. You guys have any other questions or comments, or? You think of that one?
Nice job. Thank you, Diana. Thank you, Ted.
Yeah. Thank you. All right. So is that.
Oh, I did have one more thing that I forgot to say. I spoke to, was it Students for Sustainability, Lorelei? She's awesome, by the way. We had a nice conversation, and we talked about possibly having the students do a contest, just like they did with the mascot for Think Blue, to do it for Green Yards, not Think Green. So I'll change this, actually. So that would be another nice thing, so we can have like a logo up there or something like that and have the kids be involved.
Yeah, the Eco Club.
No, it's not the Eco Club, it's Students for
Sustainability. The nonprofit they started. Yeah, that's right. But that's a Seacoast thing, right? Versus a Portsmouth thing. That's, I don't know if that matters. But.
Okay.
They're Portsmouth based.
I did have a question.
Yeah, they are Portsmouth based.
But they are the Seacoast, according to them.
They've got some kids from other schools, Oyster River, and I think Exeter High, and something like that. But that's okay.
That's good.
Kind of what we're trying to do, you know? Mm-hmm. We want to encourage them to do this in their community.
Well, if the other communities want to put a similar page on, sounds like that might be easy to do if you have
it. Well, that's it. This is the whole point this year, to make the perfect program that you can pick up and somebody else can pick up and change some of the things and run with it, you know?
Yeah.
Okay. So we can talk afterwards more about next steps, just to
mention. Yeah, and we'll have more information at the next meeting about where people think it fits. Maybe we can even have some mock-ups. I don't know how far we'll get.
So I did have one question you said on the sort of for the training. You mentioned something at our bigger meeting, our regular meeting, whether or not that the Conservation Commission would kind of support it or sponsor it. Or mm-hmm. So can you say what that means exactly?
Well, it helps to get. If the landscapers know that the city's going to be encouraging organic, you know, land practices, and they have an opportunity to get, you know, credentials in that particular area, so they'll be available to this, you know, that's a main point.
So not a financial sponsorship?
No, I don't see any big dollars being involved here. It's really space, you know, in classroom space, something like that. It fit to endorse it, you know, or part of it, or part of the Conservation Commission's, you know, outreach program.
Does the NOPA accreditation class cost anything?
Yeah, it's $400.
$400?
Yeah.
And so who gets that money? The NOPA people who do the training?
Yeah, people who do the training.
So that. I don't know if that's an issue or not, if there's money changing hands, if there's any financial. You probably know better than I would.
They're a nonprofit, yeah. You know, and they certainly don't make money, you know.
They don't make a lot of money off of this course. And actually the in-person is $800. The online is $400. And if you sign up through my nonprofit, you get a discount of $100. And we also, we've applied for a grant to fund scholarships, full and partial scholarships. So that's not something that my nonprofit would offer to landscapers, but we would offer it to, say, municipal employees or school groundskeepers or students, something like that. So. But we offer the discount to anyone who signs up through us for the online program. But the in-person is something that they haven't done for a while because of the pandemic. And then, this would be like, I think the first time since before 2020 that they're doing one, and the first time ever in New Hampshire, because it's generally run in Connecticut. And so it takes a lot for people to get all the way down to Connecticut. The hotel, all that stuff. So,
okay. Awesome. Thank you. All right, I'm good to go. So, the next item was the ordinance update. I think, I don't know, Samantha, can you hear? Thank you so much, Diana.
Yeah, thanks, Diana. Well, yeah, just some background. We sent Sam an email back just saying that it wasn't the purpose of this meeting to go over all of the ordinance changes you provided, but there's a lot here, but it might make sense to talk about the one that's specific to this. But then we should figure out a process for looking at ordinance changes, because there is a land use committee that's looking at ordinance changes. They're pretty backed up. So I don't know how quickly we can do things, but
oh.
I think if we get the necessary the ones we want agreed upon, then we'd be further along when we get there.
Okay.
So it's not time poorly spent. It's just the timing for this meeting. I think was I don't know that we ever, or maybe I've heard things wrong, but we're going to do a whole ordinance update with this group, which is going to be just organic blank term or sustainable mention.
Yeah, you're probably right, Peter. I just, you know, got excited as I was working on things and just, you know, if it's in my brain, I felt like get it on paper and at some point it'll get reviewed and moved forward. So totally fine that that's not the purpose of this meeting.
But the ones that would apply to this, is it just this one? No.
The NOFA ones?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Apply NOFA.
Yeah. So there's 1018.24. I just added a three to that. And then 0.25, I just added another line. And I don't know how people feel about those, but I thought that might be a good place for them.
Yeah, it looks like it.
That makes sense.
It's just NOFA work with wetlands and the other NOFA work that we're talking about is encouraging everyone citywide to do NOFA.
Right.
There's no teeth to it necessarily, but it's more of an educational piece. Whereas here we're actually requiring it. But I think we can do that because of the state wetland law allows us to do that. So as long as the wetlands.
And then that would be in conjunction with the brochure / I don't know what we're calling it that we would give to applicants when they came before us.
Right.
Yeah, that was the original intent we had.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So the thing, like when we get into the brochure, we can talk about it because we're talking NOFA standards on the entire parcel under fertilizers, but there's more to it than fertilizers and the standards. So we're doing.
Yeah, so are you think maybe it should come out of those subsections and make it more of a broader?
No, not at all. It's just sort
okay.
of pull out, since it's such a huge document, should we pull out in the brochure, which you kind of had done originally,
the sections on follow-up
for both of you. So that would be probably more of a discussion under the brochure, but
yeah.
I think it's the same one.
So the I guess we're not talking about it now, but we'll talk about it.
You want to talk about it too, Peter, don't you?
I can't help it.
A lot of work. Thank you.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is true.
So do you think, I think based on Kate's email, should it go on the agenda for the next Conservation Commission meeting and then we decide how we want to proceed?
I almost feel like it'd be better to have a subcommittee talk about it where they have time. Because I don't know how much we can.
I know. So then at the commission, is that where we vote on doing a subcommittee?
To review these potential edits and then vote on sending it to the maybe you edit this in a subcommittee and then vote at a meeting to send it to the whatever they're calling it.
Right, but we have to have a vote on creating a subcommittee at the meeting.
Right, so that would hopefully we'll put that on the agenda for the November meeting. Okay, sounds good. And I should mention, Allison looked at some of these with me, so I don't know if she would be interested in being part of that subcommittee, but so.
Yeah, we can invite everyone and people can sign up for their own.
Great.
So I haven't had a chance to look at this, but I've been keeping track of everybody's comments at meetings relative to ordinance changes. And so if I look at this and see that there's some other things to insert in here, send it to you right away?
Well, so I did it. It's on the, so like Kate, when I sent you the link, could you comment, do you think? Would it have allowed you to comment?
I think it would have if you had the Adobe membership.
Because I think Allison was allowed to comment when I sent it to her.
Yeah, I just printed it, so I'm not sure. I didn't
check. Okay.
But it looked, or, I could read comments, so.
If it's allowed, I can send the link, the PDF link, so that you can comment and then it's tracked right in there. But I don't, is that something I'm allowed to do, Peter?
I think if you just send it to Barbara, it's okay.
Okay. Less than three, is that the rule?
The whole committee can't edit it.
Okay.
Because that would be a meeting.
Okay.
So it really can be between you and Barbara that, you know, like you and Allison,
Barbara
could do things. And then at the meeting, we can all go over it because it's an advertised meeting to go over it. So,
okay.
But we can't really have an online meeting.
Okay. Barbara, then I'll send you the link and you can hopefully input stuff directly.
Okay.
You know, the other thing to do, Sam, is after the Conservation Commission votes to create a subcommittee, you can send this out to everybody and say, bring this and put your edits on there to bring the
meeting.
And then they can put them on there at home and then bring them to the meeting.
Perfect. Okay. But not until the subcommittee has been created.
Yeah, we can do whatever. You can do it whatever. Just don't ask anybody to email you back comments. You know, okay. I mean, that's what creates the meeting is the back and forth.
Email it, but be secret about it. Got it.
But be secret. Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
No, okay.
Secret. It's just one way.
Don't respond back. That creates a meeting.
Just blind copy people.
Okay. Got it. Okay.
Awesome. This is great. Okay. So just the last one is the brochure flyer update. And Lynn couldn't be here. And she but I had after the last meeting, and I think I brought it up at the regular meeting that I had talked to Lynn a little bit because she does outreach and education too, and she was interested in going through this brochure as sort of a, you know, starting point for making it more specific to the actual, for the applicant kind of, and have it be informative on, you know, what we're looking for from them kind of. So it's great, and it's, I love the layout, and we've all kind of gotten, I think, hard copies. Some of you might not have. I don't know, Samantha, if you got a copy of it, or I'm not sure.
I feel like you did. I apologize. I have not.
It might have been a while ago. I know I recently resent it to Lynn, but it might have been back in August or what it was said.
Let me see if I can find something. Here we go. In September 1st. I'm looking at it right now on my phone.
That comes to you?
No, not yet.
Okay.
She's going to make some changes, and then we had a brief discussion about it, and it was really just kind of taking this information and maybe, you know, just have it be about what we're expecting from the applicants, kind of, or the people that come before us. So not necessarily about the Conservation Commission. And then have it, you know, some things like where, you know, the NOPA information, she's, you know, it's great information, you've got to be allowed and prohibited. And she just had some layout, you know, suggestions that she was going to work on, but she, you know, columns instead. And then, you know, the wetland buffer document there is that drawing schematic. It's awesome. It's hard to read because it's little. So she was going to play around with that a little bit. And a few other things on there to just make it specific. And then maybe afterwards we would do one for about the Conservation Commission kind of thing.
That's a great idea.
So there's not much of an update on that at this point. There was a wetland buffer. What is a wetland buffer document that you have online, which is really helpful as background information? Mm-hmm. It kind of sets the stage, so you might try to.
We can stick it online too,
To go back and forth a little bit on that. So I don't know if you guys have all seen that document. I think you were on that one. Trisha
Miller did the graphics.
So I can send that out to everybody if you haven't seen it. It's on our website, but I'll send it out. So anybody else that wants to specifically work on that, we try to keep it down below a quorum.
Yeah, and we can put it on the next agenda and talk more. You know, if people have a lot of changes, we can bring it all, you know,
yeah,
here and kind of come with it.
Right, but she said we'll get it drafted out.
Yeah, have a draft.
Yeah, so there's no comments or questions about that. I know Lynn said she hadn't started, she had thoughts and stuff, but she's very busy, so she didn't have time to write it down. But yeah, it sounds like in the next few weeks she's gonna that was really exciting. So, I don't know if anyone else wants to do any edits or have time, but email me or we can meet and talk over what you're thinking. But yeah, and then I'm thinking a separate brochure that is just sort of informational about conservation.
Right, about what we do, or you can just apply.
Yeah,
that's a good idea. Have a few copies out. Yeah. Did you look at what other conservation commissions might have out there?
Yeah. And the state site too.
Yes. Portland has a lot of good stuff.
Software.
Yeah. Really good. What they've done planning wise there is amazing. They had one planner that was there for 20 years, it's fantastic. I've got a number of landings and whatnot. Oh my God. We just had this vision for creating a downtown where one didn't exist. And yeah, lots of other things.
And yeah, they work closely with Portland too, it sounds like.
Yeah,
a lot of things,
yeah.
So is there any other business or anything else that people want to bring up?
No.
Okay, thank you. Thanks again, Diana.
Thanks, Ann.
Thanks, guys.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Yep. I'll take it on in public works. I got a support as well. So I'll get back a little bit. But no, I think it's good. No. I think it's good.